Yes, ma'am. Jesus! Jesus! No! No! It can't be true! No! No!
Are you okay?
Holy Mary!
What happened?
I just got off the phone from Mama. I can't believe it. When you can't believe it.
Relax and talk to me. You can't believe what?
There has been a plane crash involving Papa. And there is no survivor. God, why? It can't be true. No. 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 Papa!
This love, unity, keep us together. Anali anami jaka, wana sonwa papa. This love, unity, keep us together. Oh, happiness is our journey. This love, unity, keep us together. Darling, darling. Sweetie, sweetie, oh, wanna some peace, love, unity.
The dog.
Hey,
Chiba.
The dog.
The engineer.
The dog.
What up, bro?
The engine. Didn't know you were following me.
Oh, I was right behind you.
Oh, really?
Yeah. How is your wife?
Oh, well, she's fine. And yours?
Nice.
It's good, right?
Yeah.
Bad.
Dog.
Where there is love, there is trust.
Dog.
When there is love in the family, as you and me, people say, it is not to a maker. Oh, what a beautiful family.
This is sumptuous.
Honestly,
this is sumptuous.
Thank you.
Who made this meal?
Are you asking?
I did.
You made it?
Jennifer!
Yeah.
Daddy,
say
something now.
Okay, don't
worry.
So what? You have missed her. I can do it.
Of course.
No.
She can't even boil her.
She made the food.
Who did?
She?
What happened? No. Obele, my
can.
No,
I can't.
You can't.
Yes.
You don't even tell me because I know you can't boil hot water.
You can boil anger. This will be a best for you here. With that kind of money.
Don't worry. They'll soon leave.
Yes.
Just me, eh? My children, I welcome all of you to this special day, this momentous day. I welcome particularly my sons, Ikem and Jimmy, who do not live with us, but who, of course, had to drop whatever they were doing. Finding time is part of their busy schedules. To be here, you're welcome, my sons.
Thank you very much.
And of course, you know, we abandon anything in the world just to pay you attention. It's a super late daddy.
Yes, so.
You see, I am happy. I am a happy father, I'm telling you. Are indeed happy parents. This is a happy family. And I thank God that God has kept this family going. Strong, solid, happy. Oh God, I thank you.
We need to do a cheers to that. Cheers to that. Cheers to that.
Yes, we do that.
Yeah,
we do that. Why not?
Cheers to that.
Just a great family.
Yeah, yeah,
great family. Just a great family. Yes! Good!
Mommy.
Yes, I am a happy man. Yes, go ahead.
Small boy.
You all know that before long, this pretty lady who is my wife, your mother, will be having our, how many years now?
35 years of marriage.
Yes. As we prepare towards that big event, Jimmy, now again, now, let me apologize for leaving out your wives out of this invitation. It's actually deliberate. Yes. This is a family union, okay? No problem. At other fora, all of us will be here in full force. Okay?
That's okay.
You're the boss.
Well, mommy here has some disclosures to make. It's actually a secret. With the both of us have been keeping. Yes. Edna.
To be honest with you, this is very hard for me to say. But I have to let the cat out of the bag. I'm not your mother.
I don't even know what to think. They should have told us before now that my mother died.
Oh, you heard?
She tried to, but that stopped her. I guess he didn't want us to know that we're motherless as well.
It's hard for me to digest. So what are we supposed to do? Forgive her.
Confused. She's the woman we know as mother. We confided in her a lot. And she treated us like her own kids. Good woman.
I wish. I just wish. She never told us.
That was beautiful. See the way you dropped it. It was beautiful.
But they didn't accept it. You saw how they laughed.
No, come on, Edna. They didn't laugh over it. They are reacting to what you said, you know. And maybe they found it unbelieving. But give them time. Come to accept it. Now is the time.
You know this is all your fault. Yes, I wanted to tell them this when they were little, but
you stopped me.
Had even I told them, by now, they would have forgotten everything about it and get used to me as a stepmother.
No. No. I wanted them to grow up knowing that they are motherless. Now is the best time.
Okay? Just leave it. They will grow up with it.
We shouldn't have told them at all.
I agree again. No. See, the boys are already adults. That was the best time. If we didn't, they grew up later in life, found out themselves, forgiveness would be a problem. Okay. Don't worry. They'll get over it. And of course, with time, I will talk with our daughters. See, they too were surprised.
Oh, God.
Don't worry. Everything is
okay.
Mom, we want to thank you for telling us the truth. I can imagine how difficult it was for you to make up your mind to say it out. Yes, the truth is bitter, and the shock made us react the way we reacted. I'm sorry we laughed at that time, but we just didn't expect it. I'm sorry.
Honestly, I'm sorry for everything. It wasn't my intention to keep the truth from you.
No, Mom. We understand. We perfectly understand. Okay, we know and we appreciate you for treating us like your own kids. You know, that made it easier for us to forgive you because we love you naturally like a mother, you know.
You see, Mom, thanks for accepting and treating us like your own. Not every woman will do such. So we really appreciate. And trust me, we have forgiven you.
Wow. I never knew it's going to be this easy. I'm sorry.
Nah, come on. We love you.
Thank you for accepting me after knowing the truth.
Yes.
Daddy.
Thank you very much. Thanks for being so mature about this whole thing.
You know, I'm really glad, very glad that both of you have exhibited
over the level of understanding both of you exhibited over this issue. Jenny?
Yes, Dad.
Rita?
Yes, Dad.
Come on. Yes. They're your brothers. They are your blood brothers, bound by that same blood. Okay? To them. That's it.
I'm not a
real match.
You are
real match. My daddy, I got me today.
Oh, Belenwa.
That is
Amba.
I will match daddy.
It's not, it's everything's Amba.
Why would you accept her as your mother after she lied to you and your brother?
I did. I had to do that. Okay? Because she embraced me. And I've always looked up to her since I was a kid.
This woman is obviously up to something evil. That is why she will tell you the truth, knowing fully well that you will accept her in your gullibility.
Psst. Something evil like what? How do you mean something? What are you talking about?
Ikenna, this woman is planning to take all your father's properties to keep for herself and her daughters while you and your brother sit down there thinking that she's harmless because she's your mother.
I still don't get your point.
Ikenna, my point is that this woman has succeeded in luring you and your brother to trust her while she completes her evil acts.
Amaka, why are you always suspicious of everybody? Why are you always negative? Yes. Listen, she can't do that. She's been her mother since we were kids. So I don't see her doing that. Where'd you get that from? Stop being negative, Amaka. Look, I'm tired. I want to go. I'm fresh up. Get me something to eat.
Ikenna, I know you will not believe me. I know. You better think of what I just told you. Think about it though. I've said my own.
Thank you, Amaka. I've heard you.
So, what about your sisters?
They are our biological children.
So she's not your mother?
No.
She summoned courage to tell you to the truth. So many women out there are not biological mothers to their children. Only if she has the guts to tell their children the truth.
She had to. Because such a thing can break a home when the kids grow to find out for themselves.
She enjoyed it. It's not easy for her to summon courage and tell you both the truth. And I know your late mother, wherever she is right now, would be very, very happy for raising her kid to successful and responsible young men.
You can say that again.
There's something I want to ask you.
Shoot.
Can you tell me the truth?
Yeah.
Now, are you young or that you're why is ask so silly question, Rita? I want to know.
Not to worry. She has a right to know. See, I know it came as a shock to you, the disclosures that were made. Yes. But you see, to answer your question, my dear, I am really your biological father.
I know you are, Dad. My God, you are. I love you so much, Daddy. Okay, food is ready. Let's go. Let's go to the dining and food is ready. And you, Jenny, you are here discussing and smiling with your father. Eh? And I'm in the kitchen all alone, cooking for you.
Wait your turn, mommy.
Woman, mommy. Now, why don't you let me be? Give me a little time to enjoy this period, my pretty daughter, sir. Envy.
What? And what?
V.
Me?
Yes.
Okay. All
right.
Do well. Food. Let's go to the dining.
Food, eh?
Yes.
So who's going to hold me up?
Me.
Yeah.
This love, unity, keep us together. Anelia, me jaga, wanda
so. No. Okay. Is everybody coming with me?
Yeah.
But for that,
yeah.
You know, I'm going to take you to the airport now. Let me drive you to the
airport. No. I will do the driving, please.
No, you drove him the last time he was heading to China.
It makes no difference. Let me drive him today.
All right. Let me solve the problem, right? I'll drive myself to the airport with both of you, my son, sitting in the car with me.
No.
We get to the airport, then both of you will drive the car back together. I've seen it. Take care of your wives.
Take care of your husband. Wife. Where's my wife? Come here.
Good.
You wind yourself.
Take care of her. Take care of your wife.
Sure will.
And please, look after my wife, your mother.
Who should, Daddy, me or him?
Both of you. Yes. Please take care of my daughters, especially
Daddy's girl.
Daddy's girl, okay?
Yes, sir.
Koshiaba.
So, darling, how long are you going to stay?
Just 10 days and no more.
Okay. Oh, Daddy, I'm going to miss you.
But I want to go with you.
How?
I want to go with you.
Yeah, don't worry. See ya. By this time next month, both of you with your mother, we're all going to Dubai?
Yes.
Wow. Fine.
For one whole month.
Wow.
Yes.
But you can't wait.
Daddy, let's go. Let me just can't wait. I'll see you in just give me. Let's go, guys.
All right, darling.
Hey! No, I said I'm driving, is it not? You guys say I'm driving?
Dad.
Just go, Dad.
Have a safe trip, Dad. Bye. Love you.
Love you.
Breaking news. We've just received a report about a plane crash that occurred a few minutes ago, involving Duncan International Airline that was traveling from Lagos to Bangkok with 145 passengers, all confirmed dead.
No! Malcolm! Hey! Jesus! I'm finished! No, I'm finished! My husband! No, it can't be true! No! It can't be true! It can't be true! Hey, no!
Okay, so we signed this one. I signed this yesterday.
Yes, you did.
Okay.
Thank you, sir.
All right, thank you. Where's the patient?
She's coming.
Okay. You're welcome, madam.
Thank you, sir.
How are you? Okay, just hang on. I'll just get your file now. Sorry. Hello? Yes, Chimdi. Yeah, I'm at the hospital, yes. What?
What did you just say? What? Oh, okay, I'll be home in a minute. Yes, I'll be home now. Oh my God.
Doctor, are you all right?
I just lost my dad.
I'm so sad, I'm so sorry.
Of Duncan Airline have decided, in accordance with the regulation of the International Civil Aviation Organization, through their insurers, to pay the families of the deceased victim sum of $150,000 each.
Barrister, you mean the organization is going to pay us $150,000?
Yes, it's a public news already. You can check it on net.
All right. How do we get this money?
Hold on, please. I thought we should be talking about how to retrieve your late father's remains, not compensation money.
Mommy, relax. Nobody's running away with Papa's corpse. Papa's corpse will definitely come home. But $150,000? It's good money. So we need to bury Papa from that money.
No, Chimbe. We will not bury Papa from that money. Papa has made his own money. Let's bury him from his money. You know, and I think it's my duty to go and get the money, right?
It's a...
Meaning I'm supposed to go as the first son to go get the money. Then we come back and see what we do with it.
John, yes. You go and collect the money, then when we come back home, you, Ikenna.
Oh, he come one move, John. He come on even.
Yes. Don't get me angry. I will go and collect the money. When we come back home, we now decide on what happens. Not you. Don't get me angry. Oga, how do I get that money?
All right. I will have to discuss with the management of Duncan Airline, and every other thing that needs to be done shall be done. But
Mama, with all due respect, we can not collect that money. We will go together. Yes, that's the only way.
You are my elder brother.
You are my elder brother, fine and good. But you you will not collect it. Or do you want to keep it to yourself?
Are you now the one to tell me what to do? Have you lost your sense of respect?
Yes. I've lost my sense of respect because you are a needy girl. Mama, you're not talking. If that money enters Ikenna's hand, he will lock up. Oh yeah,
could you that? What if I decide? What if I decide to do so? What will you do?
Okay.
What will you do?
You can't.
I can't. Instead of this boy to tell me, you know, ask me, let's share this. Why do you go and get the money? And later we'll talk about sharing. He's telling me about sharing with money. But I told you, you have the right to determine what I put in this house.
I have every right because that airline conversation is our father's right. Yes. Mama, you're not talking. I know you can very well. If that money enters Ikenna's hands, he will lock up. Oh yeah, could you that
you're
money?
Very stupid to say that.
Sorry?
It is very stupid.
Be stupid. Ikenna, can't wait to give a last. No, feel free. Go on. Can't wait to give a last because I will beat you like a baby here now.
Oh,
more stupid.
Stop it.
Mama, wait. Mama,
Jenny,
wait.
Stop it.
Be stupid.
I'm happy. I'm happy. On when? What are you doing here? You want to beat me? Mama, shoot.
Two of you should be discussing how to bring your late father's remains for proper burial. You are here dragging compensation money. Are you not ashamed of yourselves? Are you not ashamed of yourself? I'm disappointed at both of you. Let me ask you, Chi, will this compensation money we are talking about bring back your father to life?
No.
Then why are you dragging it?
$152,000 will not bring back Papa's life, but that's a good money. And I know he came back. If he sees that money, he will lock up. Okay, Gucci, he's a greedy person, especially when it comes to money. And I swear that will not happen.
You must beat me.
Yeah?
You must beat me.
You can't even beat me. I will warm your job.
You must beat me. See,
I will warm your job. I will warm your jaw. Be careful.
Me.
Be careful.
So look me finish.
Why don't you allow your brother to handle the money? I won't. Because I don't trust him. I don't trust him one bit. He's always greedy when it comes to money.
Okay. Well, you know he's your elder brother.
And so? He's my elder brother, fine and good. Let me tell you. If that money enters in Kenna's hands, oh yeah, good cheer. He won't give me one kobo. Oh yeah, Kuchenga, I know him. So the best bet is this. We will go there together and collect the money.
Okay, even at that, I don't want this money thing to cause any problem between you and your elder brother.
I don't care. I am saying this out of experience. Ikenna is a greedy character. We did business way back. He was supposed to give me some money. But till date, he didn't. So I know what I'm saying.
I'm at the side of this. Biko.
If you want peace, fine. If you want species, I am ready.
You know your poor mother doesn't need all this drama. She's mourning her husband, her late husband. Let her do it in peace, Biko. All this quarrel, fighting and shouting and everything. She doesn't need all this thing.
Shut up. I said shh.
I knew it. I knew things would definitely come to this. You don't listen to me. I told you your father's wife had something up her sleeve, but you never listened. You thought I was blabbing. My dear, this is just a preamble.
What are you talking about?
She knew you would fight over a small amount of money with your brother. She knew when she perfect her plans in collecting all your father's possessions. She knew.
Yes, Mama. I'm not angry with my mom. I'm angry with that brat. That little idiot, Jimmy. How much is it? $150,000. He has insulted me before the lawyer. Now I'll take it.
A money that is not even up to one tenth of your late father's wealth.
Can you imagine?
Leave this money for him.
Never! That's never gonna happen. I will never give him that money. Listen, I'm his elder brother. And I will teach that brat to respect me. By culture, it is my right to administer that money. By tradition, it is my privilege. So why would I let him push me in? It's not gonna happen. Never.
Ikenna. Ikenna, keep dancing to the evil tune your evil stepmother is playing for you. Ikenna, forget about this one and pursue the bigger fish.
Listen, traditionally, my father's properties are mine for keeps. I'm not disturbed about that. I'm not worried about my mom. She's not an issue here because I know my father must have addressed that in his will. You see that brat? I'll teach him respect.
Ikenna, open your eyes. Open your eyes.
But that brat, I will teach him a lesson of his life. In his life, the next world, he will never be so right. His elder brother, never in his life. It is my right.
Why is he crying?
Stop. Okay. You want to get fever?
I can help it. I can help it. Nobody puts it in our betrayal of others. I can help it.
Get over it. After all, they're brothers, okay? Just stop.
I'm scared. Honestly, I'm scared and disappointed at the same time. How could you change the thing and allow them to creep me? For loving something of no consequence to become an issue. Why? Why?
But come to think of it, Mom. Brother Chindi should respect Brother Ikenna. They are not mates, Mom. It's okay.
My concern is how to bring back your late father's remains for proper burial. I don't know what went wrong. Now my enemies are laughing at me. They are laughing at me.
I am sorry, Mr. Ikenna. Your father's will cannot be read now. With regards to the problems between you and your brother.
Well, barrister, my brother said he would not deal with me if he has to do with money. He has money issues with me, you know? So he's been challenging my decisions all lately. To make things easier for us, is it not better we share? You read my father's will, I take my possession, he takes his, and walk away. And there's peace. That's what I think.
Like I said before, Mr. Ikenna, your father's will cannot be read. You have to go and settle whatever issues you have with your younger brother. Then have your father buried, so we can talk about any other thing behind it.
Barrister, you're not so able. That will is my right. And you must read it to the family.
There is one thing that your father agreed to and signed on. he made it categorically clear that his will can only be read if there is peace in his family. So I suggest you go home, settle the issues in your family, like resolve whatever you have against your brother. Bury your father, and until then, I'm sorry your father's will cannot be read.
Money, money, ego, ego,
Barrister, I hope he did not see that one.
A will is a confidential report that can only be read by the lawyer assigned to it by the owner of the will. And as such, your brother cannot get hold of the will.
Listen, I know my brother. He can be very, very greedy and stupid at the same time. He might get to that will. So I suggest, give it to me. I will give it to my lawyer to keep.
Don't worry. It's safe here.
You don't understand. My brother is desperate, especially when it comes to money. I know what I'm saying. Let my lawyer keep the will.
Mr. Chinde, I assure you the will is safe with me.
What is your problem? Can't I keep my father's will? What's all this?
With due respect, Mr. Chinde, you don't have rights to your father's will as it stands now. Moreover, what do you have against your brother?
Trust issues. I don't trust him.
Where is the love?
My children, I greet you for honoring this invitation. It has been 2 weeks since your father's death news hit us. We have not recovered from it.
Oh, such a great man. Edward.
Papa! Oh, well, we want to know your plans towards the burial of your late father. Kunogwai. Can you plan a
Ndiche, which corpse are you expecting to be brought back to you people? While you know there is plane crash, and once there is plane crash, everything gets burnt to ashes. Biko, you can achieve it. Biko, once you get to that place, try to recover anything, anything at all. Even if it's ordinary thing that he traveled with that day. Bring it back, it is him. Let us bury it. Yeah, 2 weeks.
Thank you, Uncle. Imena. Uncles, I want to thank you all for what you have all said. You have all well spoken, and I can't say thank you enough. I also want to assure you that myself and my younger brother, Chimdi, we have been putting heads together to see how we can give Daddy a befitting burial. And very soon we are going to get back to you.
As a matter of fact, there is this golden casket I saw in Brazil. Yes. So I have ordered them to ship it down to Nigeria so that we will give Papa a befitting burial.
You mean to tell me that ordinary apatus you had to buy from Brazil, Bolivana?
Onyiche, come on. Give honor to whom honor is due. Papa was a great man, a wealthy man at that. But they were let go. So now that he's dead, we owe him nothing but a befitting burial. Someone is talking, I'm not done.
Thank
yet.
You for the meeting.
I said I'm not done yet.
Thank you. Thank you, sir.
Oga doctor, I'm sorry, but I can't help you.
What is wrong with you, Mr. Tunde? I gave you an instruction and you're twisting it. You're getting it twisted. Why? Why are you refusing my orders?
The existing agreement between me and your late father is that all money realized from the sales should be paid directly into his account.
And are you aware that my father is dead? Are you going to pay into a dead man's account? You're just going to pay into his account like that or your account?
Until his lawyer orders me to stop paying and then pay to your account or any other person. I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do. Absolutely nothing.
That's all right. Don't do anything, okay? And I'll prove to you that I'm the heir apparent. I am the first son. And you already know my father is dead. But let's know who has the right over this company. Your only choice. Pay into my account right now. Change my father's name. That's your choice.
I'm sorry, there's nothing I can do.
Okay, I see.
Mama, what happened? Eh? Okay, Mama, what is it? What happened? Mama, what is it? Honey, your mother was here today.
What does she want?
She came crying. She was here to beg you to stop this madness before it consumes you and your brother.
So why didn't you tell Mama that I'm fighting for my right? Am I supposed to fold my hands and watch Ikenna take everything just because he's the first son? Eh?
No. But honey, I guess I told you to forget about this airline conversation.
Listen, I cannot forget the airline conversation because it's my right. I'm also Papa's son. Ikenna has just been greedy, stupid and annoying. Yes, can you imagine? Ikenna went to the family lawyer and asked for Papa's way.
What?
Without my consent. Oh yes, you heard me loud and clear. But trust me, that will never happen. Nobody will tamper with Papa's will until the day of reading.
No, now. How could he? It's so wrong. No, I don't support this at all. I wish I knew where things went wrong. Because I know how close you were with your brother. You people were so close, loving, caring.
I'm talking about closeness. Are you talking about closeness? That means you don't know Ikenna. Once money is involved, Ikenna will forget how close you were. Simple. He's always greedy. Once Ikenna gets money, his countenance will change. But trust me, I am ready for him. My only problem is that Mama has refused to understand things with me. And you are here joining her, supporting her, because you're not making sense.
It's not
I'm fighting for my right.
Honey, that's not what I'm saying.
So what's your point?
What I'm saying is, in as much as you're trying to fight for your right, just take things easy.
No, I should romance Ikenna. I should pet him, I should pamper him.
No, that's not...
Am I not Papa's son?
I know, that's not...
Is it not our family money? So why will I pet him? Ikenna, you went to our father's cement factory and forced them to give you 1 million naira. What was that for?
And that's why you barged into my house like a madman.
Yes, because you have no right to forcefully collect 1 million naira from Papa's company.
Now get out of my house.
Sorry?
Get out!
I won't. I will not move an inch until you tell me why you collected that money. Is it your money? Don't get me angry. Don't get you angry. Don't get me angry.
Jesus Christ, this boy now does it.
More past leg, you will.
Yes.
No long.
Mm-hmm.
Ibi a mengeri. Ibi a komi. So, mtoaz you jock it. Listen to me. A man more dear na ta. Na kashigo bia. Wakamguano. Got one injection. Buy gear. Give me more. Get up! Get up!
Doctor Afonso, if I step out and come back with my Monday hammer. Oh. If I step out and come back with my Monday
now,
hammer.
Now, step out.
I swear I will break your head.
Get out of my house.
I will break your head. I will break your head.
You'll break my head.
Yes.
We're out now.
Me out.
Let's start it.
I am not moving an inch until you tell me why you collected 1 million naira from
my house. I'm
going
to leave
my house. I'm going
to leave my house. I'm going to
leave my house. I'm going
to leave my house. I'm going
your food. It's getting cold.
I lost my appetite.
You lost your appetite? Because of the MRIs your brother gave to you? Or what?
If I catch that idiot, I get him.
You better eat your food. I have told you who is benefiting from all this trouble you are having with your brother. If only you are wise enough to see business with me.
So you're calling me foolish?
Not yet, oh. Just give me time to prove to you that this woman you call a mother is behind all this trouble. You better eat your food.
I'm not hungry, okay? Thanks, son. I'm okay.
You can. Money, ego, ego, wa. I could not follow the bed. If I go, money, ego, ego, wa. I could not follow the bed. I want a girl, I'm bidding. I want a man, I'm bidding. I want a girl, I'm bidding. I want a man.
So move your car, Nana. No, sir, I'm taking my car back.
Who are you to tell me where to park?
Who are?
Mm-hmm. In Apoala. Are you crazy?
Jesus Christ.
Mm-hmm.
In Ajumbo, in Apoala.
What means you can't wait to give a last? No, no, feel free. Because if a man cook here, I will be black.
I'm waking. Keep coming.
I would beat the hell out of
you. Ujwana atoko. Ujwana atoko.
Listen.
Okay. Ilele maya siga kumili.
Neighbors, I want to hear you. Nobody will
see you. Nebongere.
This shirt is
that one. That is anger no car. This is the final battle.
I'm warning you for the very last time. Don't touch me.
Anger ko. Aku chole ko boxing. Nkogye ba. Now. In fact, you know go intravenous injection before.
Intragene.
Mbaga syringe. Mbaga intravenous injection. You survive, boy, and bump Dr. Afonso.
But that's what you got, Dr. Afonso. It's Talaja. Dr. Afonso cable. But that's by the way. This store is $1,800. If you touch it again, you'll see the other side of the world.
Check it. Where you go?
Wait for me now.
You,
if you don't move this guy, I will be sit up. Listen. Up. Listen. Yama!
Yama!
Yama! Mabuki, Yama! I'm over here. I'm my baby doctor. I will be sit on you. I will be sit on you.
Oh, you're sure I said a rat.
What? Eh! Eh! Eh!
again. Why? Why did you allow the devil to creep into this family? Barely 2 weeks your father died. I've been waiting to whatever that is causing the problem between you two to stop. He guess what? My titi. Tell me, what is it that both of you cannot resolve as brothers?
Thank you very much, Mama. You knew when all this started. It wouldn't have gotten to this. But this greedy idiot here refused to listen to me. That's the problem.
Who did you call an idiot?
Of course.
Who did you just call an idiot now?
Stop.
You see.
Stop!
Stop.
Please.
You always tell me to stop. I'm the one to stop.
Mama, Ikenna is very, very greedy. I know him too well. We did business together way back and he ate my money. And I swear it will not happen again.
You're very stupid to be referring to the past. What happened yesteryears, so many years ago. You're still coming to refer to it.
Yes, there can never be the present without the past. Mama, I refuse to be cheated. Yes, Ikenna will not cheat me. That airline compensation will be shared 50-50. And that's final.
Ikenna, please, for the sake of peace, why not go with your brother? Collect the money, share it 50-50, then we plan for your father's burial.
That's never possible.
You are waiting.
Over my dead body. Because the instruction is coming from him, this little brat. I will not obey it.
Eh?
You had better obey my instructions. I'm the elder brother here.
Eh? Then get rid, because there will be no peace. Bet me. Bet me.
Bet me.
Bet me.
You.
There will be no peace. Read my lips. There will be no peace until we share that money 50-50.
You. Bet you.
Bet me.
Me.
Ayakunaka.
So, Kogunaka.
Hey!
You are the caretaker of this house, right?
Yes, sir.
And you are aware that my father is dead?
Of course, sir. Accept my sympathy, sir.
Thank you. Your rents will expire in 2 days' time. True or false?
True, sir. You're right.
Good. I want everybody to pay into that same old account.
Okay, sir.
I repeat, I want everybody to pay into that same old account. I hope my message is clear.
All right, sir. But excuse me, sir. Seriously, I don't really understand. I mean, why the warning? Because we've been paying basically into that account.
My greedy, stupid elder brother Ikenna might come asking you people to pay into his private account. Anybody that does that will not only leave this house, but will have me to contend with. I hope my message is clear.
Yes, sir. Bye bye, sir.
How dare you? How dare you pay into my late father's account? When I warned you not to do that, I remember telling you not to do that.
Oh, guys, it's not my fault, oh. It's not my fault at all. If you really want to change things, I think you should just get a lawyer and change things for yourself.
How dare you talk to me?
So I don't like that, you know. I don't like it at all. I still have my right as a tenant in this house, in as much as I'm your caretaker. You don't come here to threaten me at all. If there is anything you have to do, you call your brother and settle things with him.
Okay. Then get ready for me. Okay? You and your fellow cohorts, your friends, coming together for war, right? You refuse to pay into my account. We will know who has the right over this property. If it's me, or you, the caretaker, or them, the tenants, we'll find out. Okay? You dare me. I warned you. You did. Okay?
It's not my fault. Leave me alone. I don't understand this kind of thing at all. I don't understand. Eh? In fact, let me call your brother. That I'm living in your house doesn't mean I can't build my own. Eh?
What is the meaning of words? They can take all this thing out of the house.
Yes, sir.
Hello, Philip. What is happening here? Why haven't you finished my work?
Yeah, Oga. Come here.
Excuse me, I'll call you back.
Good afternoon, sir.
Good afternoon, sir.
Sir, good afternoon, sir. Hey,
good afternoon, sir.
Good day, young man.
There is nothing good about today. For your own good, stop work and leave this site.
Why?
Because it's not yours.
Excuse me, young man. Who the hell are you?
I am the second son of late Chief Edward.
I see. His son, which I believe is your elder brother, sold this house to me.
On whose authority?
I have the original documents.
What he gave you are fake documents. How will you feel if you die and your sons are going to sell your properties when you're not even buried? Don't get me wrong. For your own good, leave my father's property, else Ntuaginaloso will leave with you already.
Mr. Man, you are making nonsense to me. Get out of my sight! Nonsense. Hey, the bed wood that bagari kwa numu paint you. Kikun kamsi bahinu dongwa.
Listen, your husband has sworn to keep challenging me in this house. He has sworn to make sure that I do not get my regard as the head of this house. I will pass a warning to him through you. Tell him that he's playing with fire.
No.
Money. I don't have money. What do you mean you don't have money? What do you want us to do?
Jenny, wait. Your brothers are still at home.
And I don't have access to cash right now. Yeah? Maybe you should meet one of them and talk to him. Let him give you money. Please.
Mommy, I don't like this at all. What's wrong with both of them? Who's up for? It's too much. Mom, she's right. This has to stop. We can't keep on suffering because they are quarreling. No, Mom. We have to go back to school. Since they are not ready to bury Dad.
Well, I will speak to them when I see them. But I suggest you talk to them yourselves. Maybe they will listen to you. Because I'm tired of them. I'm tired.
I'm forgiving all the tears.
Welcome. Please sit down. Let me get you something to drink.
I am not your daughter. And I can see all your cards are playing out well.
Is something wrong with you? Are you alright?
It is I who should be asking if all is well with your brain that you think me a fool like your sons. You might have succeeded in starting a war between the two of them, but I know your end game.
Amaka, I still don't understand what you're talking about. And you have just insulted me.
Oh, how I despise everything about you. I know you never supported my marriage to your son. Because you know, I am smart enough to read in between the lines. I know you are perfecting your plans and collecting all your late husband's position. But I am here to tell you that plans will not all go well for you.
Stop it! I said stop it, Amaka! How dare you? How dare you walk into my house and accuse me of something that I would never ever think of doing in my life? I'm tired of you all! Okay, Amaka? Eh? Give up!
Truth hurts. And this is take over time. Because I would rather see you dead than you take over everything. How dare you try to hit me? Try it and you will regret this all your life.
Coming to the house to see you.
Okay, I'm here. What is it? What can I help you with?
Well, we want to go back to school this weekend. And we need money for our school fees and money for our work.
Go back to school now. Am I disturbing you?
We don't have money. And we need money. We have spoken to Mom about it, but she said she doesn't have any money in time. I should meet your brother Chingy.
Okay, I don't have money. Go and see your brother Chingy.
Brother, you used to give us money now. What's going on between you and Brother Chimdi?
Respect. Respect? He has refused to respect me in this house. And until he respects me, there will never be peace in this house.
So does that mean we and our academy should suffer because of this?
Who cares? That's your business. I'm here to see Mama. She called me. Don't you?
Thank you for coming. Again, your wife was here a few hours ago. And she accused me of your disunity with your brother. She said a lot of things. There's nothing she did not say with her mouth. So I want to know, what information have you been feeding her with about me? Because there is nothing she did not say to me.
I don't understand. You mean my wife confronted you?
Yes, she did. By accusing me.
Well, if she accused you, I'm sorry, I have nothing to do with that. I didn't send her to do that, honestly.
Ikenna, you see the damage this fight with your brother is doing to this family. Now your wife thinks that I'm the one behind it. And she has vowed to deal with me.
Mama, if she said that to you and I've said sorry, it's not my fault in any way. I haven't ordered that. I've expected you by now to have called that little brat to order. To have told him to respect me as his elder brother. You just kept quiet. Just kept calm.
Ikenna, did I hear you well?
Yes, Mama. I am disappointed in you. Yes, you're not our biological mother. Yeah. But you don't have to change now. If you want this fight settled today, only you can solve it. Call that boy to order. Tell him to respect me. I'm his elder brother anyway. Call him to order. Tell him to respect his elder brother. That's what I expect from you as a mother. Not to come out and be reporting my wife to me. I'm sorry to be this.
My right ear, as the fresh sun, it is my right ear. As the head of the family, it is my right ear.
Tell me the truth. Did he touch you?
Honey, please, calm down.
It's a simple question. Why was he here?
Honey, please, can you calm down? Let me explain.
Alright, I'm all ears.
He came here to pass a message of warning for me.
He came here to warn me in my house. Ikenna came here to warn me. Alright, that's by the way. Now answer my question. Did he touch you?
He didn't hurt me. He didn't hurt me. Honestly.
He didn't hurt you?
Yes.
That simply means he touched you. Oh, you are waiting for him to hurt you. I know what to do.
Mommy, where are you going to? Where are you going to?
Listen, officers, I hate repeating myself and I can be very dangerous when I'm angry. Move this man!
Chidi, you now have the guts to invite police to my house.
Oh.
I swear, for this disgrace, you will regret this.
Dr. Alphonse, you will regret laying your filthy hands on my wife. And I will change to Ayesu. I will so deal with you. Move him!
You better ask them to leave my husband, you wicked fool.
Women don't talk when men are talking. But I'm bringing in his own kind of chili bucket. Move this man!
Relax. Hey, madam. Let's do our job.
Good.
We follow protocols.
Move him!
Sir, you know how it goes. Whatever you see here will be used against you in court of law. Just pick your stops. Yes,
ma'am. It's okay, gentlemen. Yeah, that's all right.
Olga, move it!
I'll come with you, okay?
Ecowas.
Chimdi.
I'll see you in here.
Chiwagon. Let's go. Move him!
Your brother.
I'm coming back.
Hey.
Oga, move! And I'm watching tonight, so I will so deal with you. My body depends.
Hey!
Move him! Oneko, Ekowas. This is just the beginning. Shut him, Jin.
Where is the love? Where is the love?
Honestly, Mama, there is nothing I've not said or done to make Chimdi stop. But he remained adamant.
My dear, I never knew they would disappoint me. I'm so ashamed of myself. And people are already talking. My late husband's remains are yet to be recovered. Simply because my two sons are busy fighting each other. The other day, Ikenna reminded me that I'm not his mother.
But Mama, you know he's not speaking with his right senses. They need to be stopped. I think it's high time you reported them to their uncles.
Will they listen to them? The worst part of it is that I don't even have a dime. I am broke. I can't access our account because it's a joint account. I have to wait till my late husband's will are read. Imagine, my two sons have refused sending their sisters back to school.
That's very bad of them.
Okay.
Very, very wrong. Mama, I've tried talking to my husband. He's not listening to me at all. Mama, something has to be done. We need to do something because this whole thing is getting out of hand. The other day, my husband arrested his own elder brother. You can imagine.
Adiogo.
So you meet Chimdi did that?
Yes, Chimdi did.
Chimdi came with the police to my house. Chimdi came to pick me up. He arrested me. This is serious.
It's more than serious, bro.
Me, I will tell and say, me na Esu boy, before me go John, you know, of course. So Sars they look for him, as we are, and myself they look for him. And the Inga themselves could they look for him. Too bad. But you just have to take it easy on him. He's your brother. He's just a kid. As you want a main thing, I'm a coach here. He's just acting according to his age.
You know, say, maybe he didn't know I was his brother before he started all that. He knew I was his brother. I'll teach him a lesson, a senior brother's lesson.
I'll take it easy. You can run. You can hide. I'm coming for you.
What are you doing in my house?
Can I at least sit down?
Sit down.
Thank you.
But I must warn you, my husband will never smile at you seeing you.
Oh, that I know. That is why I chose to come by this time. Amaka, please. How can we put a stop to what is going on between our husbands? Because this whole thing is getting out of hand.
Are you seriously asking that?
Amaka. Amaka, I'm here for peace. We need to stop them before they destroy themselves. Our father-in-law's corpse hasn't been buried. They're already fighting themselves over his wealth already.
And who told you that my husband is fighting over money? My husband is fighting for respect, something your husband refused to give to him. If you ever think that my husband is quarreling because of money, then you are dumb. That in fact you are stupid than I thought.
Amaka, I am here for peace. I didn't come here to quarrel you or fight with you or exchange words with you. Please, I'm begging you. Whatever the issue may be, can we please just put it aside? Let's live in peace.
Which peace? I ask you again, which peace? Peace has gone sabbatical the day your husband decided to disrespect my husband. That is the same day you were banned from ever entering this house. Now, get out of my house!
See me out?
Get out! I said get out of my house.
Wait.
I want you out of my house and don't ever come back here. Tell your heartless husband to go to hell. Get out! I don't know why you people will not leave someone alone. Come here to disturb my peace.
Thank you, my elders, for honoring this invitation on a short notice. What is bigger than the cricket has entered his world.
I hope all is well.
No. It's about my sons. I know you have been waiting to hear the fixed date for my late husband's burial.
We wanted to send a message across, at least to ask you what has been keeping you people.
My sons are the problem. They have been battling each other over seniority and the compensation money that will be paid by the airline company. As I'm talking to you now, my late husband's remains are yet to be recovered by them.
Are you saying that your late husband's corpse is still in the hands of the airline people? Oyakinagwai?
Yes. Chineke,
man. Ichi.
I've tried my best to make peace between them, but they no longer listen to me. The fight gets intense every day. I'm afraid they will destroy each other very soon.
But they were here the other day, telling us that they were planning together to fix the date of their father's burial.
I am alone.
I didn't know that. They lied to us. Sorry, right, we know what we can do. Meanwhile, we are very sorry about this. I can imagine the pain you are passing through.
What happened here? Nurse? What's going on? Where's everybody?
Sir, your brother was here. He chased everyone out, both the patients. He was even hitting us and he scattered the place.
My brother Chimdi?
Yes, sir.
Came here?
Yes.
Ha! This is... What affront? He beat you guys?
Yes.
This is becoming unbecoming. No. I gotta stop this. Everybody,
set up. Continue to put this back. Arrange yourself back the way you are, okay? I'll be back to this, okay? We will know who is the senior brother.
Madam, you are like a mother to me, and I cannot refuse you anything at it. But as it stands now, I am sorry my hands are tied. Please, I cannot grant your request. Please.
Ben, my sons are killing each other. Please,
And I don't want it to happen. Hugo, you have to read the will for the sake of peace.
But on the contrary, I don't think the will is the problem.
I know. I know. But it will help calm the situation. Please, remember what my husband did for you. He actually took you in like his son. Please.
You're right, Mom. You're right. Your husband took me in as his own biological son. In fact, I wouldn't have gotten where I am today without his support and advice. But the point is, he made me give him my word while writing the will, that his will can only be read on his demise if his children are at peace. And he signed to that agreement. You see, I cannot go contrary to that.
I don't know what else to do. Honestly, I don't know what else to do. I've talked and talked and talked. None of them is listening to me. Please help me. Help me, Ben.
It's quite unfortunate. Very unfortunate.
Maybe you can help me talk to them. Things are getting out of hand. Please.
Please. I will try.
While waiting for your brother's arrival, you want to know the reason why Bukipo have not gone to bring you the corpse of your late father
from the airline people.
Oh, Ogini Nemi. I talk to man. Ogini.
What is delaying our late father's burial is Ikenna's stupidity and greed. Yes. You all know that the airline people are supposed to compensate us with $150,000, right? Good. Now, Ikenna wants to collect that money and use it the way he wants. That is my problem. I said no. We have to go there together, collect the money together, and decide on what to do. That is the problem.
I suggest that the money should go to the pocket of the eldest brother. Because he's the eldest in the family. Mm. Isn't it?
Mm.
So because he's my elder brother, I should fold my hands and watch him misbehave. Don't you know Ikenna? Ikenna is greedy when it comes to money. I don't trust him one bit. I know him, and that's what I'm avoiding.
Chimde. Do you realize that Ikenna is your elder brother?
I do, and so?
Okay. Do you also realize that what both of you are doing right now brings shame to your family and to all of us, your kingsmen in general?
No. No. Rephrase it. What Ikenna is doing, not what we are doing. Yes. You called him my elder brother. Does he behave like one? No. For instance, you people called us for a meeting. Here I am. Where is he? No, where is he? Elder brother, where is he?
Who is that? How dare you disorganize my office, my hospital? You sent away my workers, my staff, and my patients. Today, I will return next you. I will kill you. I swear to God.
Oh, yeah.
us together. Happiness is our choice. Love, unity, keep us together. Darling, darling, sweetie, sweetie, oh, and our son. Peace, love, unity, keep us together. Where there is love, there is trust. When there is love in the family, as you want me to go, sir, it is not to a maka. Oh, what a beautiful family. Whoa, whoa, one name, alone, one name. Whoa, whoa, Emunanya maka. Whoa, whoa, one name, alone, one name. Whoa, whoa, it is not to a mama wea. Peace, love, unity, keep us together. Anali anami chaka wana sonwa papa. Peace, love, unity, keep us together. Oh, happiness is our choice. Peace, love, unity, keep us together. Darling, darling, sweetie, sweetie, oh, and our son. Peace, love, unity, keep us together.